time of day, cause I'm already getting ready. Never been afraid to talk
to the end zone.
This is some good shit.
Oh, no. Now, what's up, little man? How you living, dog? Oh, no. Hey, you want a hit, man? You want a hit?
Yeah. I haven't smoked a good pipe in a long time.
Keep going. Now, let go. Yeah. You like that, huh?
That's good shit.
Good shit. Nigga, it comes straight from Korea.
I mean, this ain't gonna stunt your growth or anything, is it?
Woo! Yeah, you my nigga, man. I like you, dude. I like you a lot, man. You know what I'm saying? I don't want you to be smoking out. I'll get you some more, dude. I ain't mad. Don't be stingy with your stuff.
You get that?
Oh, hey, man, you don't need to worry about that, little man. We just here to smoke, all right? You know.
That's me gold. Now give it back. There's a good boy.
What? Man, I'm gonna get you high and you have the nerve to ask me for my money, man? Oh, man, fuck you. You don't get it, man? Fuck you, all right? I'll hit a midget, man. Man, get the fuck out of here, you hallucinating motherfucker. What? What, you don't get in my face? Man, give me my bong back, bitch.
Damn. Oh, man.
Oh. Thanks for the smoke.
What's going on, world? Michael Beasley here coming to you from the Dreamer's Corner, episode 22. Yes, yes, yes. And today is the very special extravaganza. I mean, it's St. Patty's Day, so go ahead, everybody. Oh, shit. Put your toast up. Edward. Take that shit. Put your toasters up and put a glass up for St. Patrick's Day. Before I do anything else, I want to remind you all to please like, subscribe, share, comment. Like, subscribe, share, comment. Thank you. It is very much appreciated. And since today is St. Patty's Day, myself and the staff here at the Dreamer's Corner decided we're going to stay in tonight. Why? Well, there's a lot of police out there tonight. And, well, I don't want to go to jail. And the staff here at the Dreamer's Corner don't want to go to jail. You know why? Because we wouldn't be able to give you guys these special videos that we bring to you constantly every week. So, as I already mentioned before, like, subscribe, share, comment. So, as most of you know, here at the Dreamer's Corner, we've been holding our annual Dreamer's Corner March Madness bracket. Well, I did a bracketology a couple episodes ago. And, I might have jinxed the world if you listen to me. Take a look.
Sit back and watch history, folks. The NCAA tournament has been turned upside down.
So, you know, you guys, sometimes in life, we start to, you know. So, you know, guys, sometimes in life, we kind of, sort of, sometimes make bad decisions or bad choices or naive mistakes. So, I might have, you know, kind of screwed everybody 2 days ago, including Virginia. I mean, I didn't realize putting my opinion out into the world would traumatize the world. Legitimately, I didn't realize I was going to ruin college basketball. But I'm telling y'all now, I have bad karma. I'm an Indiana basketball fan. You know where IU's sitting right now? The same fucking place I'm sitting right now. At home. Because you know why? I ain't good enough to play basketball. And you know what? Virginia wasn't good to play basketball last night either. So, long story short, next season, don't, before you fill out your bracket, put the 16 over the 1. Actually look at it first, folks. Something I didn't do. It made you all look bad, including myself and the staff here at the Jerker's Corner, which I've heard about. Yes, Edward, I fucking know. Shut up, Edward. Just shut up back there. I know I lost you money. Shut up. Still talking, ain't you? Still fucking talking. Are you done? Are you done? Are you done now? Can I get back to this episode? I understand, Edward. I cost the world the tournament. I bombed the fucking bracketology. I get it. Now just shut up over there before I fire your ass. You're lucky you're a Pulitzer-winning journalist. Ooh, your ass would be fucking gone. Let me get back to the show now. Next up, I have an exclusive trailer for y'all entitled Sorry to Bother You. Check it out.
Man, I'm just out here surviving. And what I'm doing right now won't even matter.
Oh, baby, baby, it will always matter.
Oh. But you said you fixed that.
Get a room. I got a room, motherfucker.
Hey, Cash, how much longer I gotta wait for my money?
God made this land for all of us. Greedy people like you wanna hog it to yourself and your family and...
Me and my family?
Yeah.
Cassius, I'm your f***ing uncle.
I just really need a job.
40 on 2.
This is telemarketing.
Stick to the script.
Hey, hello. Mr. Davison, Cassius Green here. Sorry to bother.
Let me give you a tip. You want to make some money here? Use your white voice.
My white voice?
I'm not talking about Will Smith's wife. Like this young blood.
Hey, Mr. Kramer. This is Langston from Regalview.
As always, we'll be getting that out to you right away.
You're doing so good with the voice thing.
Holla, 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 holla.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Going upstairs, power caller.
They even have their own elevator.
Welcome, power caller. I hope you did not masturbate today. We need you sharp and ready to go.
Hey, I'm food trolley, they ain't murky yet. Gonna hit you, popping like Percocet. Got picked up, banger ain't surface yet. Two-stepping like the ball, this person check.
I got promoted.
I'm a power caller.
What do I sell?
They're not selling, but we selling.
No, there's no amount of money that'll make me do that.
Here's the starting salary. Well, man, I'm gonna have to get me some new suits.
Yeah, whatever I wear, know I'm here to be clear.
It is morally emaciated.
I can't ride with you.
I'm doing something I'm really good at.
Cash, I'm gonna make you a proposal. I can see that you want to say no, but I wouldn't do that before you see what I'm offering you. Cash, you are awesome.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Not going to lie, that movie looks like a straight sleeper film. Like, it looks not sleeper in the aspect of choo, like sleeper in the aspect that it's gonna blow your mind away. There's been many films like this in history. I mean, like Little Miss Sunshine. I never thought Little Miss Sunshine would be good, and it ended up actually being good. So this movie right here, Sorry to Bother You, go check it out, people, because I know I'll be in the theater this summer to catch it. So I hope we're there together. Next up, I've sent a member of my grounds team, Edward Guacamole, because he pissed me the fuck off, downtown for the hunt for the leprechaun. Because apparently, world, there's a fucking real life leprechaun on the loose. And you know what? Edward's gone downtown to find it for us. Take it over, Edward!
Curiosity leads to large crowds in Mobile's Crichton community. Many of you bringing binoculars, camcorders, even
Hold the motherfucking front door. Was that Edward James? Rewind that shit real quick.
Camcorders, even
Oh, no, never mind. Sorry, guys. That wasn't Edward James.
Camera phones to take pictures.
To me, it looked like a leprechaun to me. All I gotta do is look up in the tree. Who else in the leprechaun say yeah?
I'm gonna be honest, guys. all those people that just said yes, I'm starting to kind of believe there's really leprechauns in real fucking life. Keep going, Edward.
Eyewitnesses say the leprechaun only comes out at night. If you shine a light in its direction, it suddenly disappears. This amateur sketch resembles what many of you say the leprechaun looks like. Others find it hard to believe and have come up with their own theories and explanations for the image.
My theory is it's casting a shadow from the other limb.
Could be a crackhead that got hold to the wrong stuff and it told him to get up in a tree and play a leprechaun.
This is starting to make more sense. I agree with that woman right fucking there. I mean, a crackhead, that makes more sense than a real life fucking leprechaun, just to me anyway. Crackheads, you know, they think they got wings.
Get down to the bottom of this. Yeah, still on there, guy. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid, man.
This guy, helping to direct traffic, says he's prepared for his encounter with the leprechaun. He's suited up from head to toe.
This wars off spells right here. This is a special leprechaun flute, which has been passed down from thousands of years ago from my great-great-grandfather, who was Irish. I just came to help out.
Never have I fucking ever in my motherfucking life ever seen a motherfucking leprechaun flute. Can I get that shit on Amazon?
Just came to get lucky in hopes a pot of gold may be buried under this tree.
I'm gonna run a backhoe and uproot that tree. I want to know where the gold is. I want the gold. Give me the gold.
Well, sir, I hope you guys find the gold because, well, we all need gold in our life. Next up, Beezy's Rants.
Welcome to Beezy's Rants. Bessie, I'm going to get straight to the point. You got welfare, you got reparations, but you got welfare for what? Welfare to help the farmers or welfare to help out not the poor, but the broke that don't want to work for food? I mean, let's just be real here in this world. How many broke people in this world, let's raise our hands, have to pay for our own food? How many people don't have to pay for their own food because the government pays for it? I'm putting my hand down because I pay for my own food.
Do you know what happens when the government pays for your own food? You end up being over 200 pounds. Do you know what happens when you pay for your own food? You end up being 140 fucking pounds. So as of right now in America, we are obese as fuck, especially in Indiana. So people, put down the McDoubles, put down the Arby's dollar menu, put down the motherfucking White Castle 69 cent burgers, stop going to Denny's, stop going to Ruth Chris Steakhouse because you want to look cool, stop doing all that shit, go eat ramen noodles. So you can be 140 pounds.
Thank y'all for watching the Dreamer's Corner. I'm your host, Michael Beasley, and I hope y'all enjoyed this extravaganza of a St. Patty's Day episode. And before we get out of here, I want to remind you all to please be careful out there on those streets. And don't go to jail tonight. And last but not least, ta-ta for now.
Say what's on my mind.